Chad Corns.
A high ball. And this time, Corns is caught behind, still finishes up with the footy, and kicks another goal. Out towards the southern stand side, Harford caught behind, and Corns, he's been prominent early.
Goes over the top of Primus and Corns takes a strong mark.
Would you please welcome Chad Corns to the stage?
Chad, congratulations. Let's just raise that a little bit. There we go, mate. Fantastic. Dad's already in there. You've got a brother sitting over there that no doubt will find his way in here at the moment. You must be enormously proud to join your dad in there.
Yeah, I got the call probably a few months ago now, and I was very shocked by it. I was taken aback and not really sure where I fit amongst all these great people in the room. Obviously, grew up idolising the SNFL and Glenelg in particular, and even the table I'm on now with Chiggy and KG and Dad, sort of blows me away that I'm here with this group, so very appreciative.
Chad, you're far too modest because you fit in very comfortably, so don't worry too much about that. Now, we saw a little bit of the vision up there before. Chad Corns playing some showdowns. We've got a little bit more too. Now, I know, I think one of the greatest compliments you can probably get as a footballer is to be absolutely hated and despised by the opposition, I think, because you get under their skin so much, if you know what I'm talking about. Let's just roll some of the vision here because this is you at your best. Quincy, did you go out there and actually try and annoy the hell out of these supporters, or did it just come naturally?
My first game ever was in a showdown, and they actually clapped me as I was about to make my entrance. I started on the bench and did get on till the second quarter, and I remember the Crows crowd clapping me as the Crows home blame. And from then on, I'm not sure where it turned. I think 01, 02, when Port became really successful and that rivalry built, and you know, you finally play a good game and feel confident and... I'm not sure what happened. Might have kicked it. I remember what happened. 2002, yep. We came back from nowhere. I think the Burgoyne boys kicked three or four late goals. My mum and won the game and ended up being a bit abusive towards the Crows crowd after that. And from then, that sort of rivalry grew. And like you said, if they're booing you, you're doing something right. So sort of embraced that. And the media got a hold of it. And that was there. The best games of my career were some of the showdowns games. So great memories.
Chad, of course, so much has been made about the fact that you and Kane rocked up in power colours and Dad was a Crow. Has he reconciled that whole situation yet with himself?
Well, Kane's here tonight and I'm sure he'll agree. The most asked question we've ever been asked is, how does your dad feel about you playing for Port? It is amazing how it all turned out. Grew up absolutely hating them, as everyone would know, being a Glenelg supporter and the dominance Port had over Glenelg back in the 80s. But... since day one, I remember the first day of pre-season, the Port crowd and the Port people and just really getting behind me and supporting me and even clapping me when I was running around for that first training session. And ever since then, can't thank them enough for what they did for me and they're doing for Kane now and they've done for my family. And just, great memories and can't thank the footy club enough.
Life in Sydney Town going well?
It's good, yeah. Living in Bondi now, so can't complain. Great club up there, great people in charge. Treat us very well, good young group. obviously ups and downs at the moment, but in a few years' time, they'll be right up there. So very lucky to be a part of it.
Chad, as I said before, your name sits very comfortably amongst all the champions in the room. Congratulations. I'm sure there's some people that you'd love to thank.
Yeah, there is. I don't want to take too much time, but just a few thank yous. Start with the family, of course, and Dad. You all know him, and since I was that big, he was a legend of the game. All I wanted to do was be like Dad, but never ever thought I'd be good enough. The one moment that really sticks with me is sitting down with Dad at a restaurant when I was 15, probably. And I was, Dad, I'm not going to make the year 11 B team. He goes, okay. Let's start focusing on maths and science. And so it was sort of struck home. I could see a little bit of disappointment in his face. He never one to put pressure on myself and Kane. But from then to now, it's that's what sort of blows me away, where I'm up here talking to Dad about being in the Hall of Fame with him. So it's pretty proud of that. And that goes on to Nicole. I think Nicole was 21 or 22 when they met, which was a little bit awkward because I was about 14 or 15. Remember a few comments I got when I rocked up at the Port Footy Club, but she always took myself and Kane in as one of her own, and it would have been really hard for her. Treated us very well, so thank you, Nicole. And then that goes on to my two sisters that are there, and there's one more that's not. Yeah, I'm not sure where life leads you, but I'm glad it led there. They've been a great part of my life, and great to come home and spend this night with them. So thank you, guys. And Pammy, my mum, I don't think she could have loved myself or Kane more than she has. It wasn't easy for her growing up, but she's always just given us love. So I'm really proud to be able to bring her here tonight. Thank you, Pammy. Don't often say I love you, but I love you, Pammy. And Kane. We're very different, myself and Kane, as a few of you out there would know. But from what he's done the last few years, I just sit back in Sydney and watch what he's doing, and make sure I watch every Port game. Continues to blow me away with what he's doing, and really proud of him, his family, his three young boys. Eddie sitting there in the best outfit of the night. He's a future coach in waiting, young Edward. So love you, buddy. But Kane, remember the last kick we ever had of the footy together? It was before my last game on the Friday at Footy Park before that Collingwood game, and that sits very well with me. So very, very proud to be able to play so many games with you. This is going too long. My friends, the people I've met through footy has been the real highlight for me. The people I've been able to meet just from being associated with footy, and the way the fans and everyone's treated me, I'm very blessed. So thank you for having me, guys. Appreciate it.
Congratulations to Chad Corns. There you go, mate.